All right, guys, and welcome to today's trigonometry class. And today we're going to talk about solving right triangles, but more specifically, or before we do that, we're going to talk a little bit about significant figures. So significant figures are used mainly to make certain measurements precise. For example, I use this one all the time. When you go to the store and you buy something, you don't pay $1.253. Because that just doesn't make sense. It really just, you wouldn't know what to do. So you just pretty much end up paying $1.25. So one of the uses of significant figures, especially when we're working with measurable quantities, is to maintain a degree of accuracy, as close to precise as possible. So if we're executing operations and let's say we have, 3.22 plus 1 and we'll say that they're both meters. So if I have this, right, you can execute an operation with measurable quantities and take into account the significant figures or significant digits, as they're called in some other books, and you can add that. And I know that this is going to be 1, and this is going to be 5, and this is going to be 6, and this is going to be 4, and I have... of course, meters, right? So I have 1, 2, 3 significant figures here, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures, and my answer has 4 significant figures. So whenever you're adding, subtracting, multiplying, or dividing measurable quantities, and you want to take into account the rules of significant figures, our answer is supposed to have the same amount of significant figures as the number with the least amount of significant figures. And I know that really sounds like a mouthful, but what I'm trying to say, breaking it down to you, is that if this one has 3 significant figures, this measurement, and this measurement has 4 significant figures, sorry about that, and this measurement has 4 significant figures, then that means that my answer is supposed to have 3, because I'm going to have the same amount of significant figures as the number with the least amount of significant figures, which means I have to include the 4, the 6, and the 5. But I also want to include the rules of rounding. So if I look at the 5, next to the 5, there's a 1. So I say that my answer is 4.65 meters, right? 4.65 meters. And again, this applies to to measuring significant figures or digits and all that stuff. It applies to adding significant figures or multiplying significant figures or dividing significant figures, okay? All that stuff. That is what it applies to, okay? So what does that have to do with trigonometry? So in trigonometry, when we're working with right triangles, we're usually using measurements as well, and it's good to understand this rule. So for example, let's look at example number 1. I'm going to do example number 1 here, and I'm going to try to the best of my abilities to draw a right triangle. And we'll have this right triangle here. And the right triangle has beta, which measures 45 degrees. So we'll say beta right here is 45 degrees. Alpha, I don't know the value of alpha. A, which is down here, I don't have any value for A. B is 27.3. meters. 27.3 meters. And I have my C. So in this exercise, in this example, and I'm going to read from the book, the example says, determine the number of significant digits corresponding to the given information in the following triangle. Measure of an acute angle and a side length in solving this right triangle. What number of significant digits should be used to express the remaining angle measures and side lengths? So real quick, to break it down, to go straight to the point, the question that's being asked is, if I were to solve this triangle, how many significant figures would the answer have? If I were to solve this triangle, how many significant figures would this answer have? Okay. If I were to solve this, how many significant figures would this answer have? So they're not, they don't, the problem's not asking me to execute any operation or find the angle or find the sides or anything like that. It's just saying, if I were to hypothetically answer this, what or how many significant figures would my answer have? Well, in this case, what we would do is we would just look at the measurements that I have. And I have side B, which is 27.3 meters. And I have my beta, which is 45 degrees. So the question then would be, how many significant figures would this have? Well, very simple, guys. All I have to do is count the, and this is side B. All I have to do is count the amount of significant figures in each measurement. So if I look at B, it has 1, 2, 3 significant figures. And if I look at beta, it has 2 significant figures. So that means that the answer should have 2 significant figures. And I'm going to type that up down here. The answer should have 2 significant figures. Again, 2 significant figures simply because 45 degrees, which is beta, has 2 significant figures. And that's all you really need to do for that example. Again, it's a real easy example. It's not out of the ordinary. It's not complicated. In fact, it's super easy. Which then brings me to example number 2. And this is going to be the last example for this video. Today's video is relatively short. I'm going to go ahead and go ahead and delete this. And example number 2 is also a right triangle. And it says that beta in this case is 56 degrees. So 56 degrees. Alpha is what I'm looking for. My hypotenuse is 15 feet. And B and I have A. Let's see if I can write this a little better. This is 6. Okay, 56. I know that's nothing like the triangle that you have there. And they're asking us to find A, alpha, B, and A. You don't really have to find them in any particular order. Your book starts by finding alpha, then side B, and then A. In reality, it doesn't make much of a difference. In fact, I would just leave alpha for the end. And that's exactly what I'm going to do in this video. I'm going to start looking for A. A is relevant. Or so all I have is a hypotenuse, which is 15, an angle, and A. So I need to use the trigonometric functions, okay? So if I'm looking for A, if I notice A is adjacent or close to 56 degrees, and this is the hypotenuse. So to find A, we would say the cosine of 56 degrees equals A, which is my adjacent, over hypotenuse, which is 15. So we would obviously need a calculator to solve this. Now, what I do is I like to do this. I like to just say, well, this is over 1. And since there's an equal sign, I can just kind of create a proportion. And just I just cross multiply. A times 1 is A. And, of course, I have on the other side the cosine of 56. Times 15. And that's all I did, just multiply the cosine of 56 times 15. And then if I go to your textbooks real quick, when you look for the calculator and you multiply that, the answer that you get is 8.38789. So give me 1 second. So I say that A is approximately 8.38789. Now, we're using or we're taking into account the rules of significant figures. So if I look at 56 and I look at 15, they both have 2 significant figures. So that means that my answer is going to have 2 significant figures, which would mean 8 and one other number after the decimal point. So I know A is going to be part of my significant figures. And one other number, because the least number of significant digits is 2. So I know it would be 8 and one number after a decimal. Well, I look at the 3, and next to the 3 I have an 8, so that means that I round up, and I would say that my answer is approximately 8.4. And that's how I would find A. Now I'm going to look for B on this side. And B, if I look at, notice B, B is opposite of 56. And I have 15, which is my hypotenuse. So in order to find B, I would say the sine of 56 equals B, which is my opposite, over 15, which is my hypotenuse. So again, I like to do it this way. You don't have to. You can do it algebraically where you multiply 15 on both sides and whatnot. But I like to do it this way. I just write it as a proportion. And I can only do that because there's an equal sign here. So I just cross multiply. B times 1 is B. And then, of course, That leaves me with the sine of 56 times 15. Sine of 56 times 15 times 15. And you're going to multiply that, and you're going to get approximately, of course, in that case, 12.43556. So B is approximately 12.43556. Now remember, I need two significant digits because 56 and 15 have two significant digits, which means that I just leave it at 12 because 1 and 2 are significant. So my answer would be, or I would say that B is approximately 12. And that would be the value of B. Now to find alpha, it's really simple because I know I have beta, which is 56, and I also have a right angle, which is 90. So to find alpha, I just subtract 90 degrees, which is the right angle, minus 56, which is the given value of beta. And that equals 34 degrees. So that is it for this video lesson. The assignments have been given to you. They were, I believe, page 52. Problem 1, 2, 11, and 13, guys. So stay safe until we see each other in the next class. Bye.